Hi, and welcome back to another episode of the Friday Show.
Next Wednesday is another big basketball game against the Oliveira Eagles. Let's go, Wolverines!
Girls play at 3:30 and the boys play at 4:30.
This is our final home game. If you haven't seen the game yet, this is your last chance.
Next Monday is President's Day, where we honor our past presidents on George Washington's birthday.
Which also means there's no school.
Donate books to Read Across India to help encourage reading all over India.
Submit your books to have been at the office before February 24th.
Enjoy the show!
Oh, I'm sick today, everybody!
Hope you feel better soon, Mr. Hogan.
Well, there's going to be a substitute for the next few days until I get better. So I expect all of you to do a really good job. Bye.
After saying goodbye, we silently filed into the classroom. Our sub, Mildred, was waiting patiently for us to begin DOL. DOL stands for Daily Oral Language and is a large part of our daily routine. We quickly started after unpacking. We felt bad that Mr. Hogan was so sick, but we were really warming up to our substitute, Mildred.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This week is becoming even better and better. We got to sit down and listen to a story read by Miss Mildred. Whenever we listen to a story, we try to form a picture of how the characters and setting look. This activity also helps us improve our listening skills and how to pay attention. We always have to listen to the story carefully so that we can be able to answer any questions about the story that the teacher gives us. A book that Mr. Hogan read to us was Boy of the Painted Cave. It relates to our social studies unit. Right now, we are listening to one of Miss Mildred's favorites, Smart Dog. We are really enjoying this book.
This day, we did a math lesson on inverse operations. Inverse operations are operations that undo each other. Subtraction and addition are examples of inverse operations. Division and multiplication are also examples of inverse operations. We also learned about using the balance scale method. When using the balance scale method, the goal is to isolate the variable by subtracting or dividing the coefficient by itself. Then, you get what the variable represents. Here, Ms. Mildred, our substitute, helped us on using the balance scale method. We use these cool doggy treats as math manipulatives. You know, I think I even saw a student hand a manipulative and Ms. Mildred ate it. I wonder why.
Today is Tuesday, so we have to go to the library. Our substitute, Miss Mildred, told us to stand in a straight, single-file line. We also hold our books near our chest so that we don't make them fall to the ground. Our substitute hurt her foot today, so we had to push her in a wheelchair. As sixth graders, we have to be good role models for the younger grades. They have to know how to stand in line properly. Since we are the oldest, we are the only ones who can show them the right way to do this. Aren't we the best at lining up? If the younger kids see us, they would make the school a better place. You try to learn from us as well to make the school a better place.
Towards the end of the week, we were all very excited to do our weekly 10 extra PE minutes. Mrs. Mildred led our stretches very well. She was very playful and ran around in circles. It almost looked like she was chasing her tail. Our substitute was a great leader and really enjoyed the power walk. But she was going really fast and we had to run to catch up to her. At the end of extra PE, we all felt really energetic, especially our substitute. It felt like we did our stretches for a lot longer than 10 minutes. But we're sure that she knew what she was doing. I wish we got to do our stretches for a little longer.
Each day that Miss Mildred subbed for us, she wore a different outfit. It was really entertaining for us and it helped us pay attention in class.
On this day, our substitute was teaching us about honesty and integrity. She taught us that we should not lie. She said if we didn't do our homework, we should not make up an excuse like my dog ate my homework.
This is also important because in our class, we try hard to follow the 8 grade traits that include honesty and integrity.
On this day, our substitute teacher taught us about the process of mummification. She is wrapped up like a mummy and put herself inside a sarcophagus. Our sarcophagus is a stone coffin usually found in Egypt. A few students open the coffin to reveal Miss Mildred, our mummified substitute. Near her heart, a student spotted a strange-looking object called the scarab beetle. The scarab beetle symbolizes the restoration of life and the 8 great traits. The different colors used in the scarab design had meaning. Red meant the god Ra. Touches of yellow were used to symbolize the sun and the desert. Blue symbolized the Nile, and the green meant the symbol for growth. I know for sure that we will all remember this very important lesson.
Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Mr. Hogan.
Boy, it's sure good to be back. I was so sick the last few days, and I'm so glad to be back. I see that you had a note from the substitute, and looks as if you did pretty well, but I kind of had a hard time understanding what her writing says, but I think you did a good job. So how did things go?
Good!
Yes, Venkata?
We all felt bad that you were sick, so we pitched in and bought you a present.
Wow, thank you. Wow, this is so nice of everybody. What is it?
It's a one-way plane ticket to Oregon.
Oh, how nice. So thoughtful. Thank you, everybody. This is really, really generous of you. Yes, Aditi.
Mr. Hogan, while you're gone, could you please request Miss Mildred to be our substitute?
Yeah!
Well, I could, but, wow, this is just so very, very thoughtful. Thank you. Wait, one-way ticket to Oregon? Miss Mildred? One-way ticket?
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
While the party was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a pool with shout out.
Who let the dogs out?
All this rain we have been getting has been great. Our state has been in a desperate drought for years, and this precipitation is very necessary. But so much water, so fast, has been causing many problems. Rock slides, mudslides, downed trees, and overflowing rivers have caused accidents and damage all over the place. The most recent trouble was caused by the rain has been in Oroville, a town north of Sacramento. Lake Oroville sits right above the town, and the water is being held back by the Oroville Dam. With all the rain, the dam has been pushed to its limit and is in danger of busting. Erosion has caused the water to damage the dam, and if the dam bursts, water would rush into the town. The Feather River runs through Oroville, and if all the water from the dam were to rush into the river, the town of Oroville would be underwater. Authorities ordered an evacuation of the town while they work on a possible solution. Over 100,000 people had to pack up their cars and leave the town. If the dam breaks, they could all lose their homes and whatever couldn't fit in their vehicles. More storms are expected to slam Northern California later this week, so officials are scrambling, working frantically to drain water from brimming Lake Oroville in hopes of stopping a potentially devastating flood.
The 59th Annual Grammy Awards were last Sunday night, and the music industry came out to celebrate the best of 2016. As she did in 2012, Adele swept her nominations. Adele is the first to twice sweep the Album, Record, and Song of the Year award. The night's other big winner was David Bowie. Even though he passed away last year, Bowie was a groundbreaking artist who was successful close to 50 years. Bowie took every award he was nominated for, including Best Rock Song and Best Rock Performance for his deeply moving Black Star. The arrival of the night went to Chance the Rapper, the Chicago-born rapper who has controlled his career independent of the major label system. Chance won for Best New Artist and Best Rap Album for his album, Coloring Book. There were many incredible performances at this year's Grammys. Lady Gaga with Metallica, The Weeknd with Daft Punk, Katy Perry, A Tribe Called Quest, and not to be outdone, Beyoncé put on a theatrical production that brought the house down as well as stopping social media in typical Beyoncé fashion. Later, accepting the award for Best Urban Contemporary Album for Lemonade, she glowed. One of the final performances of the night was Bruno Mars's late show tribute to Prince, who also passed away last year. It was an enjoyable night of fashion, music, and of course, some politics.
NASA's Near-Earth Object Observation Program has discovered and cataloged over 15,000 near-Earth asteroids since they began scouring the skies in 1998. However, every now and then, one manages to escape their powerful telescopes and keen eyes. This was certainly the case with asteroid 2017 BS-32, which was discovered on January 30th, just 3 days before a close encounter with Earth. The asteroid, which was moving at 9.9 miles per second, came within 101,214 miles of our planet at about 12:23 p.m. on February 2nd. NASA's researchers say that the flyby was a surprise. The space rock, estimated to be just 39 feet in diameter, would have not caused any damage, even if it had hit Earth. What worries experts, however, is that 2017 BS-32 is the latest in a series of previously unknown asteroids that have snuck up on us unexpectedly since the beginning of the year. The largest surprise asteroid this year was 2017 AG-38, which came within about half the distance between Moon and Earth. Paul Cox, the chief astronomical officer at SLAW Observations, says it raises a few eyebrows when we see a number of close approaching near-Earth asteroids over such a short period of time.
Hi, I'm Meryl with this week's Brain Teasers. Last week, primary brain teaser was, what has a neck but no head? The answer was a bottle or a vase, and the winners are rooms 211 and 209. Remember to write... remember to write your room number on your submission. Last week's intermediate brain teaser was, poke your fingers in my eye and I will open wide my jaws. Linen cloth, quills, or paper, I am greedy and devour them all. What am I? The answer was scissors, and the winner is room 406. This week's primary brain teaser is, take off my skin and I won't feel pain, but you will cry. What am I? I repeat, take off my skin, I won't have pain, but you will cry. What am I? This week's intermediate brain teaser is, I am black of eye and bright of hair, and my feet are firmly in the ground. I love the sun upon my face, and I follow it around. When I am dead and gone, 'tis said that I will droop real low, that I will keep the birds well fed, standing stiff there in my row. What am I? I repeat, I am black of eye and bright of hair, and my feet are firmly in the ground. I love the sun upon my face, and I follow it around. When I am dead and gone, 'tis said that I will droop real low. Then I will keep the birds well fed, standing stiff there in my row. What am I? Remember, submit your answers by the end of today, or we do not see them. Anyways, that's it for brain teasers.
We need to submit stories to the Friday Show, sixth graders.
Please be sure to include your name, room number, date, and a proper title.
There is also not going to be any Friday Show next week.